Hey guys, it's Desiree back with another video. Today we're gonna do a get ready with me. So pretty much I'm just gonna be doing my makeup and talking to you guys and all that. So I guess I'll kind of tell you too what some of the products are that I'm using. So like usually whenever I do my makeup, I moisturize first and I use this Glam & Glow that I got from my BoxyCharm. It's pretty good though, I like it. If I'm looking down, it's because I have a mirror right here. Yeah guys, so today it's gonna be like I'm gonna be trying to do some type of, what is it called, a New Year's look, because tomorrow's New Year's when I'm filming this, and my birthday, my 23rd birthday on New Year's. I'm a New Year's baby, so trying to get a little bougie for the occasion. I don't really know what I'm gonna do, but something that matches the shirt, because this is what I'm gonna wear. Ignore my hair, guys. I know it's looking crazy, but like, I do my hair at the end. I don't do my hair to start, because like, I feel like hair, you can always just like do whatever with it, but like your makeup, you have to take like more time on that. To me, that's what I think, because you can always throw your hair however and make it look good, but your face, you can't do that with your face. So what do I need? Okay, so I'm gonna start off with some Control Freak. I just got this off of Amazon, to be honest with you. It's okay, it's a brow gel, and I just kind of do this to my eyebrows. Yeah, I love doing my makeup. I don't know how good I am at it, but I love doing my makeup. Like, I know my brows are just terrible. Terrible. Right now, anyways. So, yeah, I just do it however I feel. You know, I feel like there's no wrong way to do makeup. However makes you feel good, you know? So, that's what I do. So then I kind of let that dry on my eyebrows, and then I go in with some, okay, this is gonna sound weird, but this is what I've been doing lately. I'm not a makeup guru. I don't know what's right, what's wrong. I just do whatever I think, and if you like it, you like it, pretty much. So if I like it, you know, that's how I'm gonna do it. Anyways, pretty much, I get this blush stick by Color Block, and I put it under my eyes because like I kind of have some purple under there, and like color correction with blush, I don't know, I think it works, not too sure, but I'm doing it. I mean, I haven't heard any complaints yet. I don't know if you should really be putting this next to your eyeball. I'm not gonna go tell you guys to do it, because hey yo, if you lose an eye, I don't want to be responsible. Then I get this concealer. I've been really liking this concealer. It's called Dose of Colors Concealer. And I got it from my BoxyCharm. Sorry guys, my nails are all the way jacked up. But ignore those. But I feel like it kind of does dry quick, you know? So like, I'll put some on like that. And then I'll get this little beauty blender. I can't remember. Ignore me if I make any weird faces, people. I think all of us girls know when you do your makeup, you have to make a makeup face. You have to make a makeup face. I don't really do mascara, but when I do it, though. Because I don't have eyelashes. I might do eyelashes today, honestly, since it's going to be my birthday. I don't know. It's New Year's Eve, so we'll see if I do lashes or not. I got these magnetic lashes too, so. Dude, BoxyCharm has been like a game changer for me. A game motherfucking changer. To be honest. I just do the same thing to the other eye. I don't know, I feel like it looks like so much brighter. I don't know if the blush really does anything, but to be honest, I think it does, so that's what I've been doing now. I really started doing that too. But yeah. Put this on. This is how I do it anyways, cause like this mama be having eye bag circles from all these damn kids. I don't know, I really like this concealer, it looks really pretty. And no, I do not set my under eyes because those bitches are gonna crease regardless, no matter what I do. Cause like, I've tried like 3 or 4 different setting powders and like, I feel like they make like the bottom of my eye look super cakey. So I'm dry, so I didn't even go there cause I have dry skin as it is and I ain't trying to look crustier than I already am. I know, I think it's really pretty. Okay, so now onto my eyebrows. I use the Milani. Actually, I'm running out of this. The Milani Precision Brow Pencil. I used to use the Dip Brow, but I felt like it was like too harsh for what I was going for, so I stopped using it. Either that, or I just don't know how to apply it. But who knows? So then I do put some like on the front of my brow right here. Like I try to do like a light line. And then I just go with the rest of my brow. What are you guys doing for New Year's? Having a party or are you quarantined or what? I know the COVID's been sucking to do anything. Like, I'm gonna go to my in-laws tonight. We're gonna hang out with them. See where the night takes us, I guess. I don't know. And then I just use the spoolie to like blend it out. This comes with the spoolie on it too, but like, I don't know. I feel like it's not as good as like the spoolie I have, so. And then like right here, I do like little flips. This is like get ready with me. Desiree tries to do a tutorial even though she doesn't know what the fuck she's talking about video. That's this video. So I'm all over the place with it. Try to act like a beauty guru up in here. Like, look at me. I know how to do my makeup. Maybe not. I mean, I think it comes out decent, you know? Like, who knows though? Who really freaking knows? Okay, so I kind of just did the other brow off camera because, like, nobody has time for that, you know what I mean? Like, it takes me a while. I don't know. I think they're cute. I don't know. Anyways, they're decent for today. They've been better. Yeah, all I did off camera was like conceal them and whatever and like do the left brow. Okay, so after I do my brows, what are we gonna do today? Okay, let's do some eyeshadow, I guess. I'm gonna do something that matches my shirt. Yeah, but I'm gonna use some eyebrow I'm gonna use some eyeshadow primer. I'm gonna use this one. It's Visor Professional Makeup Paris. I could be saying that right. I don't know how you say that. It's really good though. And if you guessed it, I got it from BoxyCharm. I'm sure none of you guys. guys could guess what I was gonna say. Cause I've been getting like 80% of my makeup from BoxyCharm. So then pretty much I just like slop it on there. Just rub it out a little bit. Honestly, I have nothing planned for this. I'm just gonna go with the flow and hopefully it turns out good. No, but this primer's super, I love this primer, it's so good. I had the Morphe eyeshadow primer, and honestly, my opinion on it, I hated it. Cause like, it would set on one eye good, and then not the other. I don't know what I was doing wrong though. Who knows, it was probably just me, but yeah, this one's a lot easier for me to use. So what kind of look should I do? Let's see what I have. Palette I'll use. What if we do, we'll do a neutral look. A neutral with a tiny bit of sparkle, I guess. Okay, I guess I'll use this palette. I have so many palettes. So many palettes. I have like over 20 palettes. I don't know if that's a lot. It's a lot to me. Because I can't use all those. I'm going to use this Spanglish one, I guess. One of the colors out of it, anyways. I think I'm going to use this brown one. The ha ha ha. Yeah. I'm going to use that, I guess. And then I'm going to use probably the Natasha Denona palette. This one I got from my BoxyCharm too. It's so good. Probably going to end up using this one in that look too to like deepen up the crease or something. And then like the sparkles from that. Oh, and I have this. This isn't an eyeshadow palette, but let's just say Desiree likes to use a lot of stuff that aren't supposed to be on your eyes. On your eyes. Don't try it at home. Anyways, this one, I'll probably use some of these brown shades, even though I have like 1,050 palettes, but this is right next to me, so that's what I'm going to use, because I don't want to get up and get another one. These are plenty enough to like do the look I want to do. What brush should I use today? I guess I'm going to use this brush. This brush is 35E, I don't know. Oh yeah, here it is. The Farrah 35E brush. I guess I'm just gonna go in like all over with like a, what is it called? Just like a color to go over the whole eyelid. I'm just gonna use the Ha 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 from the Spanglish palette I showed you guys. Just put that everywhere. Oh, and I have Morphe palettes and all that, guys, but I'm just like using what's right here because those are her. In that back drawer. It'll be fun. I use this actually a lot. I always have like this for my eyes, honestly. So this is like a realistic get ready with me, you know? Cause like this is some shit I'd really be doing on the daily. My eye looks so stupid and I'm trying to look up and do it at the same time. Yeah. Pretty like put it all over. Yeah. Honestly, I love doing my makeup. It's like therapy. This is literal therapy for me. Like, I love doing my makeup. I don't know how good I am at it, but I know I like doing it. And that's one thing too about makeup, like, there's no rules to makeup. You just do it how you like to do it. Like, you can't tell somebody you did this wrong, you did that wrong on makeup. Come on. Makeup is self-expression. Self-expression, people. You can't judge somebody else's artwork. Okay. Now I'm gonna go in with a darker shade from that contour palette, I guess. Do I know what I'm doing? No. I just do what looks good to me. So I'll kind of just put it here probably and just like work it in my crease. I mean, it's not much darker, but I want dimension. Trust to be beauty guru. pretty much. Like, I never plan these things. I just kind of go with it, to be honest. I don't know. Anyways. Put some makeup on my fingers. Okay, now I'm going to go in with that Ha Ha Ha, the one I was going to use, but then it was too dark. Now I will go in with that one. Kind of top it. Yeah. Back and forth. I mean, can't believe I'm turning 23 already. I remember I was just turning 20 yesterday, and I'm turning 23. Like, I know that's young still, but honestly, I feel so old. So, like, don't come back at me when I'm 33. It's just, like, I really didn't want to leave my teenage years. And now I'm already 23. What the hell happened? Where did time go, dude? It just flew away. This isn't the most flattering. Oh. If you like it, you like it. If you don't, you don't. Blending it and blending it. Okay, now I'm gonna get like a little deeper of a shade, but I'm just gonna put a little bit of that because I don't want it too like crazy bold today. I'm gonna get this color. I don't know what the color is. It's what is it? Sorry guys, I got a phone call, kind of ruined my vibe, but ignore it if you hear anybody in the background, because there's people here now. So yeah, I was telling you guys about my Glamnetic lashes that I'm gonna do. This is kind of a better look though, for like a better angle for, I don't know. Okay, I'm gonna do these. I don't know how I feel about magnetic lashes yet, but this is gonna be my second time using them, so we'll see what I think. I don't know how I feel about them, to be honest with you guys, though. Like, I'm used to, like, putting my lashes on the bottom of my eye. Like, on that little line. So, like, I don't know. Yeah, so pretty much you just get this little eyeliner, I guess, and you put it on your, like, line, and then they go on. Magically. Like, honestly, I just put it exactly where they end and start, and then I use a different eyeliner. Sorry, guys, if you hear the background noise. So, like, I guess I'll line like that. Like, I'm gonna go in with my eyeliner too, guys. So don't worry. It says that these are best when it's 80% dry. Sorry guys if I'm being quiet. It's because like I need a full concentration. Usually I don't do my eyeliner like this. I usually do like the little wing first. And then I fill the rest in. But like, since I'm doing the magnetic lashes, I'm not gonna do that. Let's see. They're kind of still a little dirty from last time I wore them because I didn't clean them. I only wore them once, so. Sorry guys, if you see my big old mess behind me, because I need to like put away my laundry and like throw away boxes from Christmas. And, I have a lot to do. But I do have a futon right here that I'll be filming like my try-ons and stuff over the stupid laundry is right now. But just need to get time. I went ahead and I did the other other eye off camera. I don't know how good that looks. But anyways, yeah, I did the other off camera because we ain't trying to have you guys here all day now. Because, you know, it's a process. Anywho, so after that, I guess I'm going to, like, spot conceal. Because I don't like to do foundation all over my face. So like I spot conceal. Yep. So just get the same concealer I had. Like on my chin. I like broke out there like 6 months ago and I have scars because you know I'm trash and like had to pick at it. You know, this is what happens when you pick at your acne. Don't do it. It's not worth it. Cause now look at me. Look at me. Blend it in. I love the small beauty blender though. It's so good. I love this concealer. It's so cute. Honestly, I only conceal the areas that like bother me the most. So then I do like where I had like two little acne spots. That. Blend those bad boys out. Right here in between my eyes because I kind of had like a small breakout there, plus I have scars from, you know, being trash. You know, I love to be trash and jack up my own face. Like, only if I wouldn't be so tempted like to pick at my face whenever I got one freaking pimple, like for real. I know there's more of you trash people out there that can relate. Why do we got to do that to ourselves? Why? All I want is perfect skin. I mean, my skin's not terrible, but I make it terrible by freaking picking at it. Really isn't a vibe. Sometimes I don't do it around my nose, but sometimes I do because you know, I was like the red stuff. I'll just put a little bit. Okay. Blend some out. There it goes. Don't judge my mustache. Not all of us can be hairless cats. Just kidding. That's funny. Okay. Okay, So that's how I conceal. Then after that, peeps, let's put away some of the shit because I have shit everywhere. Sheesh. I need some room to move. So yeah, like I do like minor contouring just because I don't want to be like that bitch, but I do some contouring and a little bit of bronzing depending on the mood. So what am I getting? Oh, yeah. This is like a contouring sponge because it has like this line. I feel like that looks good. Maybe, maybe not. Don't tell me. Unless it's good, then tell me. If it's good, tell me. If it's bad news, don't tell me. That's how we're living right now. Don't judge me. And then I bronze it up a little bit. I just put a tiny bit of bronzer, honestly, with you. From this thing. I think I got it from Ulta. It's the Physician's Formula Bronze Booster. Okay. Just a little bit of that and a little bit of this. Now I'm going to put my blush on. The blush from this iconic London thingamajigger palette. So good. I love blush. Like, there's times where I'm into it and I'm not into it, but, like, I'm into it now. This blush right here, so good. Because, like, I feel like it looks natural and it's not shimmery. I like cream blush, though, too. It's just the mood, but lately I've been using this one. Sorry, you don't need to see that Christmas wrapping paper trash bag, because I'm trash. I know. Don't judge me. Don't judge me. At least it's in a trash bag. And like this room, it's pretty much just for like my husband's clothes in the closet and my vanity. So it could be a little messy from time to time. But, you know, we'll get on it. We'll get on it. Isn't this blush just, like, what? Like, who is that? Who am I? I'm everything. That's what I am. This video is gonna be long as hell. Sorry, guys. Sorry for putting you through this trauma. Anyways, so then I get the highlighter from that. And like I put it on the highest point of my cheekbone because, you know, I think I'm a beauty guru. Low key beauty guru. So yeah. Then I put some on my nose. Glop it on there. Put all of it on there. Make sure you're covered in glittery highlight because who doesn't want to shine like a star? Okay. Then I just blend it out with my finger. Because we're trying to shine, but we're not trying to shine bluntly. We're trying to shine subtly. My finger for this, to be honest, because I don't like take a bunch of the product off. I just want to like blend it out. This does not do justice for this highlight. It doesn't.
After that, I pretty much turn like, sorry guys, hopefully you guys can like see my face. Okay, now let's put the mustard. Should I go with like a dark brown? Or should I go... I'm gonna go with whatever I want. Let's see. I'm gonna go with dark brown. I need something that matches. Not matches, but compliments. What I have to put on here. This is very lipstick. I have Lash Glam at 1.2, which I did like it, but then I started like, seeing reading lipsticks really quick. So then I was like, you know, I'm gonna switch to something else. Because I have Hello Lipstick now. Which isn't a bad thing. I guess we're gonna go in with... Let me see what this looks like. I have so many that I can't even wear them all, to be honest. We're gonna go in with some Sugar Daddy. Because we all need this. Don't tell my husband that. Don't let him know. Just kidding. Okay. So... now what we do here is, like, wing it. This is really pretty with the shirt. That's pretty. And see me, like, you see how my lips kind of come up to a point? I kind of, like, to accentuate that and, like, be, like, Angelina Jolie vibes, you know? Let's do that on the side.
So guys, this is the finished look. Thanks for joining me with the Get Ready With Me. It was actually pretty fun for my first one. But be a sweetheart and subscribe.